Hi, my name is Amanda Linneman. I'm a burn ICU nurse who got into the industry about 10 years ago as a wound care specialist, and I've been in research and development for the past 6 years. I've then serviced over 1,000 nurses on the QiVi male external urine management device, and today we're going to talk about some of the most frequently asked questions that I hear about on a regular basis. So, QiVi is a male external urine management device that utilizes suction tubing and a wall canister to divert the urine away from the patient. QiVi comes in a single-use pouch and has directions with pictures clearly on the back. The device itself is intended for male patients with urinary incontinence who are semi to non-ambulatory. The device should not be used on patients with female anatomy if they have an allergy to any of the device materials, urinary retention, or penile complications like lesions or wounds. For a full listing of contraindications, please refer to the instructions for use manual. Now let's get into some of those questions. I'm typically asked if you need to prep the skin prior to applying QiVi, and the answer is yes. You do want to clean the peri area prior to applying the device. You want to wash and dry the area, and that's going to ensure you get the most optimal adhesion possible. Also, if you have any skin prep readily available, we recommend using some of it around the base of the penis. It'll help you also get a great adhesion. When you're using skin prep, you do want to make sure that that skin prep is allowed to be completely dry before applying the device. Is trimming of the perineal hair follicles required? Not necessarily. It's really going to depend on the patient's hair growth. Coarse, thick hair, trimming is definitely recommended. Now, QiVi can still work in the presence of hair. However, hair acts as a barrier between the adhesive patch and the patient's skin, and we do want to minimize any barriers so we can achieve the best seal possible. Another question I get is, can I use QiVi over a lesion or wound site? Unfortunately, the answer is no. Wounds and lesions are contraindications for the use of QiVi. If your patient does have a skin lesion, inflammation, irritation, or ulcers at the site of the adhesive patch, please avoid using the QiVi device. Is the adhesive supposed to be placed on the scrotum? Yes, it is supposed to be placed all the way around the anatomy. So whenever you're smoothing it out, you want to make sure you go all the way around and you do place it on top of the scrotum. This will ensure you have a closed system. Another question I get asked a lot is, how do I place QiVi on a patient with a high BMI or in super large abdominal panis? So for patients with a large abdominal panis, you just want to make sure that the panis does not obscure the tubing. To do that, you may have to turn the device slightly perpendicular either side, and that's okay to do that. The device has tubing that runs bilaterally down both sides, so even if the device is on its lateral side, it'll still continue to suck up the urine away from the patient and keep the patient dry. I wanted to take a minute to show you how to use the QiVi device on the retracted anatomy. So, your goal on the inverted penis is not to find the shaft, but just to find the urethral opening. So you're going to do your best to find that urethral opening. If you're lucky, after digging in there, you're going to get something that looks very similar to this, and that's fine, that's all you need. You're going to take the device, using the urethral opening as your dart, and this as your bullseye. Go ahead, line up those targets, hold the device, do the peel one and the peel two, hold the device for a minute, letting it conform. What you're going to notice is that when the patient urinates with those retracted penises, it kind of fountains out, sprouts out. So you'll notice that the suction tubing that runs bilaterally sucks it up really, really quickly. I think you guys are really gonna find this, the QiVi, to be a lifesaver for your retracted anatomy. Can QiVi work in lateral position? The answer is yes. QiVi is a completely closed system, so it can work in lateral, supine, and even seated position. In fact, as long as QiVi is connected to the suction canister, You can use QiVi in many positions. How does QiVi prevent incontinence-associated dermatitis? Well, first and foremost, from the beginning, it's going to keep your patient clean and dry, both outside of the pouch and inside. That is because the bag itself is vented and there's constant air circulation inside, creating the perfect microclimate for adequate skincare. The inside of the pouch is also hydrophobically coated, so no moisture can stay within the pouch. If once your patient voids, within 60 seconds, all the urine is suctioned out and your patient is completely dry. All of these factors play into keeping incontinence-associated dermatitis at bay. Is QiVi compatible with an MRI? The answer is yes. QiVi is compatible with an MRI, CT, and X-ray. There are no electrical, metallic, or ferromagnetic materials inside the device to hinder any of the scanning. Is it required to always carry a portable suction machine with you if you're just ambulating your patient for a short duration of time? No, you do not need a portable suction machine if, say, you're just ambulating your patient short period or moving them to a cardiac chair, or say they're just going down to X-ray. All you need to do is take some Kelly clamps, clamp off the top, or you can grab a suction cap and do the same. The device itself can hold 250 milliliters of urinary output should the patient void during that short time. So although the device is intended to be used with continuous suction, it is not required to carry a portable suction machine.